아, 안녕하세요. 매일매일 운동하기를 실천하고 있는 동탄왕코입니다. 카메라 휘었어. 카메라가 휘었어요. 아, 오늘은 토요일 아침입니다. 날씨가 너무 좋아요. 지금 햇살 보이시나요? 거실에 불은 안 켰습니다. 안 켰음에도 불구하고 이렇게 밝아요. 행복하십니까, 여러분? 행복하세요? 저는 오늘 야간 출근입니다. 밖에도 안 나가고 집에만 있어요. 날씨가 너무 좋아서 나가서 놀 사람들은 나가서 놀겠죠. 하지만 저 오늘 세탁기를 돌리고 이불 빨래를 하고 집안 청소를 하고 오전이 순삭당했습니다. 이 우리 집의 마지막 남은 식물이 죽어가고 있어요, 지금. 햇볕을 많이 받고 있는데. 살아나야 될 텐데, 내가 물을 너무 많이 줬나? 자, 아무튼, 운동하겠습니다. 역시 운동할 땐 CNN이죠.
Africa telecommunications.
We're going to have the strongest connectivity business across Africa.
All new today on CNN in association with Afreximbank Bank. Connect the world with Becky Anderson.
It all starts here. Changing, fighting, creating, connecting. That's why we're here. We live here, we work here, we're from here, and we'll go wherever the story takes us.
I'm Becky Anderson in Tehran. We are in Jerusalem. Real news that shapes our world. Exploring not just what's going on, but why. I just want to press you on one further point. Getting perspective on this region from this region. Places that many of us know, but few of us get to see. Observing countries on the move, still rooted in tradition. It all starts here, and that's why we're here, bringing you the world from our Middle Eastern hub.
Connect the world with Becky Anderson, Monday through Friday on CNN.
When news happens, anywhere in the world, CNN is there.
We've all been detained by the Russian authorities.
No other journalists have been allowed into Myanmar since this coup happened.
It's easy to spot ambulances like this one racing all over the city, going on call after call.
It's been 10 years of unimaginable horrors.
Do you know who these children are? Have you seen them before?
I need urgent support, urgent help.
We will tell the world your story.
Sunday, the Iran nuclear deal. Former President Trump walked away in 2018. Will talks now underway in Vienna create President Biden's path back in? Is that even a good idea? Fareed Zakaria, GPS. Sunday.
I'm Matt Rivers in Rio de Janeiro. This is CNN.
Thank you.
Hong Kong, and this is CNN. Sometime tomorrow, Buckingham Palace expected to announce the full funeral arrangements for the Queen's husband, Prince Philip, who died today at the age of 99. He was in poor health, but the palace says that he passed away peacefully at Windsor Castle. Philip's death, another blow to the royal family, which is still reeling from accusations of racism made by Prince Harry and his wife, Meghan. I want to bring in now CNN royal correspondent Max Foster. Max, hello to you. Thanks so much for joining. Reactions around the globe to the death of Prince Philip. What is the latest there tonight, and which is tomorrow morning, where you are?
Well, the Queen is obviously having to deal with what happened yesterday and then also sign off on the funeral arrangements. Prince Philip was very involved in his funeral arrangements. He didn't want a lot of fuss, but he did want the charities and the causes and the military associations that he built up over his lifetime to be reflected in that. A lot of that won't be able to happen because of the pandemic and the restrictions. So there won't be any processions. So what we expect to hear on Saturday, after the Queen has signed everything off, is that everything will be contained within the castle walls behind me. Perhaps a funeral next weekend, but it'll be limited to 30 people under the current restrictions, unless some sort of exemptions have been made here. So we're waiting to hear those details. I know the Queen would have wanted Prince Philip to have a bigger family, really. She feels he made a very big contribution, not just to the marriage, but the monarchy and also the Commonwealth.
You know, Max, Meghan and Prince Harry put out a short statement on the front page of their Archwell Foundation website following the news of the death, and it says, in loving memory of His Royal Highness the Duke of Edinburgh, 1921 to 2021, thank you for your service. You will be greatly missed. So Prince Harry was very close with his grandfather. Do you expect him to attend his grandfather's funeral?
Well, as you say, he was close, and after the Oprah interview, he went out of his way to say to Oprah that Philip and the Queen were not the people he was referring to in reference to that conversation about race of his unborn child at that time. So he was protecting Philip to that extent, and he did that because he does look up to who the person who was the patriarch of the family. I think he would want to come. I haven't spoken to anyone on his team about this yet, but I think it was, you know, we would expect him to want to come. The Duchess, not so sure. She is pregnant, of course, and the numbers will also be restricted, so it'll depend as well who the Queen signs off on the guest list as well. But I think he would want to come. If he does want to come, there is a quarantine process. He'd have to be in quarantine for at least 5 days. He'll be able to do that if he left soon, but we'll wait to hear on that.
Former President Barack Obama posting a beautiful tribute to Prince Philip, sharing a photo of him and the former First Lady Michelle Obama posing with the Queen and the Duke. At the Queen's side, or trailing the customary two steps behind, Prince Philip showed the world that it meant to be a supportive husband, what it meant to be a supportive husband to a powerful woman. Yet he also found a way to lead without demanding the spotlight, is what is written there. So what will Prince Philip's legacy be, Max?
Well, it's interesting, isn't it? Because we will know him as the person who supported the Queen, was always by her side. She will remember him as a husband, but also the one person she could be normal with, which is hugely important when you are a member of the royal family. Even her own children bow and curtsy to her when they first see her. Philip was the one person that could be himself with her and was very honest with her. She would take his advice. She described him as her strength and stay. And you will hear people who know them very closely talking about how she couldn't have done it without him. He had a huge contribution to her monarchy, which is one of the great monarchies in British history. Some would argue the greatest monarchy. So she's lost her closest advisor, and I think that's the key part of you know, what's happened today. So his legacy will be what he did for the crown, also what he did for the family, because behind the scenes he was the head of the family, who would make all the key decisions. There was some sort of deal there between him and the Queen on that. He was very much a leader behind the scenes. And he made a lot of compromise, I think, over the years, but he did that for his wife.
Max Foster, thank you for staying up late or waking up early, whichever it is. Thank you, we appreciate it. So he fired up Trump supporters just hours before the Capitol insurrection.
his lies so bad that his own party thought about removing him from committees. But Congressman Mo Brooks could become Senator Mo Brooks soon, so stay with us. We'll talk about that.
Welcome to Doha from every one of us, even those working quietly behind the scenes, so you can relax and enjoy the perfect break in your journey. And when you leave with a smile, we know our day's work is done. Qatar Airways, welcome to our home.
Take the vaccine when it's your turn.
Vaccines, weapons against a pandemic.
If you don't get vaccinated, you have zero protection.
But why do people fear that?
Misinformation being spread around the neighborhood is taking its toll.
It's a beautiful document that's completely full of lies.
Join Dr. Sanjay Gupta on a journey to find the answers.
Where is the anti-vaccine information coming from?
CNN special report, The Truth About Vaccines, Sunday on CNN.
Businesses are transforming, preparing for a future where innovation will change the way we live and work.
It's going to be, and it is, the most significant development in photovoltaics in 65 years.
It is an essential building block in providing clean and affordable drinking water.
Explore the future of business. Go to cnn.com/business evolved in association with Vodafone Business.
Looking at climate adaptation strategies for farmers, and more than half the world's farmers are women, and that's their primary source of income. So how do you make sure they have drought-resistant seeds if they live on the edge of the Sahel? The Sahel Desert is moving down, as we know. How do you make sure they have flood-resistant seeds? Because the farmers will tell you the rains are coming much more often, or sometimes they're coming less often, but when they come, it's a ginormous flood all at once. And so they need to have seeds and have mechanisms for learning more about when are the rains coming? How do we get information out there? So we're looking at all those types of adaptation strategies on the way to the world getting to zero emissions by 2050. Because they are the ones most impacted, which are people who are in poverty.
Business never sleeps. As the sun sets in Seoul and Shanghai, deals are signed in Dubai, and Europe is already in play. New York prepares to make its first move. I'm Julia Chastley, journalist, global market analyst, and host of CNN's newest business show, First Move. Join me in the financial capital of the world for a market-moving perspective on the news influencing global politics, culture, and finance. I'll speak to newsmakers, risk-takers, and the ultimate game changers. Bold moves, big deals, winning trades. It's all right here. CNN, your first move.
First Move with Julia Chatterley. Weakness on CNN.
Trump's staunchest ally is now running for an open Senate seat in Alabama, and he could win. Another example of Trump's grip on the GOP and how far right politics are now mainstream in the Republican Party. Here's CNN's Manu Raju.
He was one of the architects behind the big lie that Donald Trump won the 2020 election, firing up Trump supporters at the Stop the Steal rally that preceded the deadly January 6th riot at the Capitol.
Today is the day American patriots start taking down names and kicking ass.
And now six-term Congressman Mo Brooks is being rewarded with an endorsement from the former president, as Brooks now seeks the Alabama Senate seat being vacated by retiring Senator Richard Shelby.
He saw the crooked election, what happened, and he was willing to speak up.
Trump choosing Brooks over his former ambassador to Slovenia, Linda Blanchard, and before others could jump in. Though Trump's 2017 picks in the Alabama Senate primary and general election both lost, this time it could be different, with Republicans seeing Brooks as a clear front runner, all thanks to Trump. Appearing last month with Trump advisor Stephen Miller at his kickoff rally, Brooks repeated the falsehoods about the election and compared it to his 1982 bid for a seat in the Alabama legislature, where he contended that machines would not allow votes to be cast for him. While he won that race, what exactly happened then was never fully resolved.
When I saw what happened last year with Donald Trump, I recognized it pretty quick because I'd seen it before.
As one of the staunchest House conservatives who was elected in the 2010 Tea Party wave, Brooks has emerged as one of Trump's biggest defenders. During Trump's first impeachment proceedings in 2019, Brooks and other House conservatives stormed a closed hearing about whether Trump withheld military aid to Ukraine as he pushed for an investigation into the Bidens. Asked by CNN at the time about a key witness's testimony, Brooks erupted.
Mr. Brooks, the opening statement says very clearly, let me finish my question. He says
you
very clearly.
You should not be relying on it.
I'm asking about the substance of what he said. He
that
said
didn't make
that,
any difference. We don't know whether what he said is true or not because of the sham process that's being used.
He has also refused to take any responsibility for inflating the January 6th rally goers and for giving them false hope that Congress could change the electoral outcome, repeating the big lie just hours after the pro-Trump mob stormed the Capitol.
Non-citizens overwhelmingly voted for Joe Biden in exchange for the promised amnesty and citizenship, and in so doing, helped steal the election from Donald Trump.
His actions alarmed colleagues from both parties, with CNN learning that Republicans privately considered stripping him from his committee assignments. Republican Steve Womack told CNN he played Brooks' rally remarks to his GOP colleagues.
And where Joe's from?
Yeah.
Do you think he incited the rioters?
I'm not going to get into that. He offended me, I can tell you that.
But Brooks has remained defiant.
Do you regret speaking at that rally last week?
I did my duty for my country.
Now, even though some Republicans were concerned about what Mo Brooks did in the run-up to January 6th, he received no punishment. He's still serving on his committees, and he could very well be a United States Senator next year. And one reason why is Donald Trump is still popular in the state of Alabama. He won that state by more than 25 points, and Republicans believe that there's very little chance that Democrats could pull off an upset in that very red state like they did in 2017. So whoever wins that primary could very well be the winner and could become the next United States Senator from Alabama. And at the moment, Mo Brooks appears to be the favorite. Don?
Manu Raju, thank you very much for that. I want to make sure you know about the new CNN original series, The People versus the Klan. It tells the story of Beulah May Donald, a black mother who took down the Ku Klux Klan after the brutal lynching of her son, Michael. Watch back-to-back episodes Sunday at 9 Eastern right here on CNN.
Oh, gosh.
Behind this.
That was my baby, and nothing they do can bring him back.
Could not be higher.
story of Carnage. A powerful new CNN original series, The People vs. the Klan, Sunday at 9 on CNN.
Selling you your smartphones and electric vehicles are worth trillions of dollars. All those devices and cars have cobalt in them. But the people digging that cobalt out of the ground earn a dollar or two a day. That's an injustice. That is modern slavery, and that cannot stand. My name is Siddharth Kara. I'm a British Academy Global Professor and an adjunct lecturer at the Harvard Kennedy School of Government. For the last few years, I've been traveling to the Democratic Republic of the Congo, and I've been researching cobalt mining. What I've seen in the Congo is hell on earth. There are children caked in grime and filth, digging in pits and tunnels to excavate cobalt-containing ore, and that ore gets processed and refined and sent up into the formal supply chain to smartphone makers and EV manufacturers around the world. I think the most important thing young people can do is to be aware of the fact that the children in the Congo scraping and scrounging for cobalt are directly touching their lives every day. And I think knowing that and spreading awareness of that is the most important first step. And awareness will lead to action.
I'm Selena Wei in Hong Kong.
In central Kalimantan, Indonesia.
In Beirut.
In Tehran.
On the Congo River in Kinshasa.
Lagos, Nigeria.
In Moscow.
In London.
Mexico City.
Manaus, Brazil.
The White House. And this is CNN.
All new African voices change makers. Create opportunities. Impact communities. Transform lives. Top rugby players make a difference on and off the pitch.
I basically want to give back in a big way, and I want to inspire a generation of leaders and unlock the greatness within them.
African Voices Changemakers, only on CNN. Sunday, Michigan's coronavirus crisis. What's behind the state's dangerous new surge? And what's being done to stop it? Lieutenant Governor Garland Gilchrist talks with Abby. Inside Politics Sunday with Abby Villa. Sunday on CNN.
Changing the world. And since 2007, CNN Heroes has celebrated hundreds of these amazing individuals. They are all around us, and you can help shine a light on their efforts by nominating them as a CNN Hero. Here's Anderson with more.
It's been a time of challenges and change, but it's also a time for hope.
You know we can do anything.
This year, CNN Heroes celebrates our 15th year, honoring everyday people doing extraordinary things. From frontline workers fighting against the pandemic to those battling for racial equity and social justice.
Oh.
Spontaneous acts of courage to those who've dedicated their lives to making a difference.
We need to see the world differently.
Anyone can have impact no matter their age.
Everyday heroes are all around us. Do you know a hero? Tell us about them. Nominations for 2021 CNN Heroes are now open at CNNHeroes.com. Now, more than ever, the world needs heroes.
And remember this, you don't need to personally know your hero to nominate them, and it only takes a few minutes. You can do it right now at CNNHeroes.com. Thanks for watching, everyone. Our coverage continues.
Across Africa, businesses are working together like never before. All new on CNN, Connecting Africa.
Join me and Lenny Jokas as we crisscross the continent to show you how new connections are revolutionizing commerce in Africa. This month, Connecting Africa through telecommunications.
We're going to have the strongest connectivity business across Africa.
All new today on CNN in association with Afrexim Bank.
Generally, we love meat, cheese, eggs, you know, dairy, everything that comes from animals. Generally, we grab plants, feed them to animals to produce our traditional food. And now we want to take the animal out of the equation to really create a more efficient, better, more sustainable, but also very, very delicious food system, everything coming from plants. So there are many, many plants out there that we have no idea what they do. So what we created was an algorithm that would allow us to predict which combination of plant-based ingredients should result in the same sensory experience as a traditionally animal-based product, such as milk. So the algorithm keeps getting smarter and smarter and starts to understand the underlying patterns between the molecular components in food and the human perception of taste, texture, smell, color.
When news happens, anywhere in the world, CNN is there.
We've all been detained by the Russian authorities.
No journalists have been allowed into Myanmar since this coup happened.
It's easy to spot ambulances like this one racing all over the city, going on call after call.
It's been 10 years of unimaginable horrors.
Do you know who these children are? Have you seen them before?
I need urgent support, urgent help.
We will tell the world your story.
Oh, I don't know.